everybody, and welcome to my channel. My name is Mai Brox, and happy Easter, everybody. This channel is where I show a little bit of my knitting and crocheting and sometimes sewing and other things that I do for or as a hobby. But today it will be mostly knitting and a little bit of crocheting. And we will dive right into it. Usually we start with what we are wearing, so I will quickly show you that. I have this fantastic shawl, which is a design by Steven West. I was gifted a yarn pack from my husband last Christmas, or not last Christmas, but the Christmas before. Christmas in 2022, when I was brand new at knitting. So he gifted me this yarn pack. So I started, I kind of learned how to knit through this shawl. So this shawl is, I have to zoom out, it is fantastic by Steven West. Where you are starting right up in this little top there, and you work your way out. Now I will not say we're going behind this, and I will show you the whole shawl. So this shawl is knitted in Arvetta from Filcolana. Beautiful. I guess that it's a sock yarn, really, but it's very nice yarn. I really, really like it. This sweater is called Ingen Dikke Dare by Petit Knit, knitted in the Dream color from Hobby, together with a kid silk from Viking. Ingen Dikke Dare. I don't know if they have a English name for it or not. So today in Norway it's rainy and it has been quite chilly, so it was quite good or nice to be having this shawl on me. Yeah, so that was what I'm wearing. So Steven West shawl fantastic, and Ingen Dikke Dare by Petit Knit. Steven West had a make-along, a mystery make-along, starting in October, as I have understood that he has that every year, and he started that in October 2023, and I had never participated in that. And I thought that would be so much fun to do, because I really like him and his pattern. I think he's brilliant, the designer, and when he makes patterns like this, that even a newbie like me actually was able to knit, then he is amazing. So I bought yarn at Unique Yarn in Trondheim in my colors, and I was so looking forward to making one of his shawl with that. And then this mystery knit along came along, and I wanted to do that. So I did part one, or as good as fully. I did not have any much left at all before it evolved into a big controversy, huge discussion of what people actually saw in this role or not. So it ended up that he took part one down and he remade all of part one. But I had already done part one. And I had been working so hard to work to together and not falling back on it. Because if I was to fall back on it, it would be harder for me as a brand new knitter to work myself in again, and if I was falling too far back, I probably wouldn't have finished the shawl. So I worked so hard to make part one finished this before part two came out. So when all this shit hit the fans, then I had already done part one, and I really wouldn't rip everything out and start all over again. So I didn't. I decided to continue, and I did part two, and then I started on part three. But I really lost the interest and the love for it and the joy completely. As the weeks went by, it was less and less fun. It was at the end, it was not fun at all. And even if I would make the shawl, I was quite sure that I would hear about it and hear the and yeah, why didn't I change it like he wanted us to? And yeah. Anyways, so I was like, okay, this isn't fun, it just kills my joy completely, so I threw it away. And then now in January, I really wanted to finish up some UFOs, and I wanted to start on new shawls and new things, but I really couldn't, I felt that I couldn't start a new shawl while I already had one shawl going on and was supposed to be working on that. So I kind of had to finish it, and I have, and I really love it because after all it is my colors, I have chosen it, and I will wear it because I like it. And now there where I I like my shawl, and since it is kind of my colors, it matches a lot of my wardrobe. Anyway, now I will shut up. I have completed it. I'm so happy that I did, because then I can start on a new shawl, and I have wanted to do a Vertices Unite for so long, but I will talk about that later on. Anyway, so here is my GeoGradient shawl by Steven West. If I could open it up, so I will show it, and I will not speak when I am behind it. So this is how it looks now. It goes out on this side. And I want to show you a little closer up. You can see, look at that pattern. I mean, it is amazing. I love this part. It is, now this part, it wasn't hard to do, but you really had to keep your rows or your ducks in line. because if you kind of miss one, everything would be out of line. So, but it was very, very fun. So it wasn't hard, but you had to keep focus. So, but this border here was just fun to do. I loved it. He calls them a deep stitch. Very kind of deeps into, yeah. Love it. I would love to have a bigger border, a thicker border, making it bigger, but I did not have enough yarn. So, yeah. So this is my GeoGradient shawl. And like I said, because it is my colors, it goes to so much of what I usually wear. I love it. Now you probably have guessed already, but I like purple. Purple is one of my favorite colors, but then again I love all the colors, so who am I kidding? Yeah, I knitted this in Holst super soft yarn. Don't think that it is super soft. It got much better after I washed it, and yeah, but still not really my favorite yarn. I don't think that I will buy more of it and knit anything else in it. Yeah, did not really like that much. Yeah, so it's done, it's finished, and it yeah, it's mine. My Geogradient shawl by Steven West. Yeah, I also wanted a kind of a Christmas shawl. Now I started knitting one, and I made the Sophie shawl, or I started on a Sophie shawl, just that I made it with thin sock yarn. So I made it with this hobby Christmas sock wool glitter yarn. Let me see if I can come on. Yeah, anyway, this is the yarn, Christmas sock wool glitter. And I did not make it before Christmas, but now I have one for this year. So I have some tassels at the one end, and this is how it looks. It is okay. I'll set up when I'm at the or behind this. It is over 4 meters long. It is 4 meters and 20 centimeters long, so it is quite a long. Now it didn't become a shawl really, but I have a really really long scarf, so a long Christmas scarf that will go with my winter jacket and winter coats. So yeah, I love this. I love this. It's going to be very nice for Christmas this year. So that's my Christmas scarf. Yeah. So, and I really wanted to dedicate at least March month for socks, and I really have. But I also have finished up some socks that I started on. These pairs I actually started in September, I guess it was. It is with a hand-dyed yarn from Kvitlamme, which is called Høstsang, which means fall song. So this is the color. Beautiful. So that is that sock yarn from Kvitlamme. And this black is cash sock from Jaguar. So beautiful. Now this black part is a leftover yarn. So so I made a couple of banana socks. I think they are brilliant because you can make them, and they more or less fit any size. If you don't know exactly what size you should make for other people, then a banana sock would fit them anyways. So yeah, the what will change is how long the cuffing or the leg will be, because if you have like a really long foot, then you will have a shorter leg. Now if you have, for example, like this is a 36-37 European shoe size, then you will have quite a long leg. But banana socks are made with knit temple stitches, 4 knit rows, 4 purl rows on the one part, and then we have like a normal ribbing with 2 knit and 2 purls there. I have videos that show how I make these ones, how I am making the anan socks. So, and then I start from the toe and going up. That is my preferred way, because then I can make them as long up the leg that I want to. So I find it easier to make socks from the bottom and, or from the toe, I mean, not from the bottom, but from the toe and up. So that was one pair of socks. So yeah, after I have done those shawls and scarves that took forever, and bigger things, I usually like to do small things. And then I really needed a hairband that could hold my hair back when I do stuff. So I crocheted a hairband. I took an elastic ribbon, elastic thing, and just started crocheting on the one end and working my way down and around and around and around, and then I attached it to the other side when it was long enough to fit my head. And since it is elastic, it fits me very, very well, and it is easy to get on and off, so I can use it this. For instance, if you are putting on your makeup and or you are making some food and you don't want hair falling down everywhere, I think this is really nice. Or if you just want to be cute, you can push it back and use it like a, yeah. So quite easy, it did only take one day, so nice and easy thing to just relax with. Yeah. Yes, I have a cup of coffee. Socks, yeah. Those, as you can see, those banan socks are quite clever that way, that you don't need to make a heel. They don't have heels, so but in a book that I bought, there was this pattern for, or this whole book is very easy patterns, and one of them was a sock pattern that I haven't seen before, but I have heard about an afterthought heel, and this book actually showed it. So this I have made. I can put one on the sock blocker so I can see how it is. So this is in Norwegian, it is socks with a peasant heel. I don't know why if peasants use this heel, but yeah, anyway, it's an afterthought heel, that is what it is. So in this book, we started from the top and working our way down the leg, and then we just knit in a thread where we later wanted the heel to be, and then we just kept on working down to the toe and cast off and everything. And then you took this thread that you had knitted in, just like you do when you are making a mitten for the thumb, or when you are making the thumb on a mitten or gloves, you knit in a thread that you later remove, and that's what you do here. And then you are picking up stitches, and you are knitting around and making the heel. Now this was so clever and so easy, and I was like, finally I can make regular vanilla socks, just plain easy socks without all that big fuss with that heel. So I think this was brilliant, brilliant. This pattern is by a woman called Siri Nilsson, and this book that I'm talking about is called Siri's allerede enkleste oppskrifter. It means Siri's easiest patterns, and it really, they really are easy. Is patterns for beginners, or if you just want to have something or to make something that you don't really have to think too much and sit and count and count and count. Yeah, something you can just work on in the front of the TV or when you are social or in the car. When someone else are arriving, yeah. Then a friend of mine showed me this sock, and I was like, oh my god, I need that. I think that was super cute. It's called Flockensocken, which means the pack sock. Look at this. It's a pack of sheep. Now, for me, who are spinning wool from sheeps that are that live nearby here, these are just amazing. And we usually need socks when we are meeting up for like a spinning cafe or things like that. We are spinning in thick socks or yeah, something other than shoes on our feet. So I think this is this was so smart. They are warm and they are super cute, so I'm looking forward to be wearing these. Yeah, the yarn that I made in this is a Sportsdragen from Viking Yarn. That was the pack. And around a year ago, I saw this yarn pack from a Norwegian store called Atelier Margareta. And I thought that this socks was just the cutest thing that I have ever seen, so I had to order that pack. Now, I hadn't really made socks then, and that heel I thought was going to be so hard. But now I have knitted them, and I love them. They are the watermelon socks. Have you seen something cuter? I mean, they're so cute. I really, really love them. What I don't like is that you don't knit this green part here or the seeds. They are sewed on after you have knitted the whole sock. And this sewing now embroidery is not my thing. And I guess that you can see it. I can at least see it. It works, but it took so long and it was boring, and I had to redo it and redo it and redo it. And I mean, seriously, next time if I'm going to make this again, which I think that I will knit this green part and these seeds. I will definitely not embroider all of this green, maybe the seeds, and maybe I'll even find some pearls and stuff and put on for the seeds, making them a little bit more fancy. I don't know, but I will not sit and embroider or sew on all of that. That was I hated that, and I still hate it. Now, I did it because the pattern said so. I'm a good girl. I do as I'm getting told. Yeah, but they are done. I got a costume, so I will be wearing this one, and I love them. I think they are super cute. Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4. socks nowadays, but Panama's socks, I don't know who's for, but so four pairs of socks and one scarf and one shawl. Yeah, that's not too bad. Then I want to show you a little bit what I am working on now. Now I have this Easter calendar from Janne's Verden, which is just amazing. And I want to show you a little bit from there. So it is an Easter calendar, so I'm getting these small packages every day with handmade labels on them. And she also, in number one, we got this little handmade book that she actually made out of paper bags. So so we are getting different, you can see here there are paper bags, and we have some small labels that are made. And the thing is that we are getting one of these gifts every day, containing what we need to do one little part of a pattern daily. So there are 10 gifts in this calendar, so the Easter lasts for me 10 days. Yeah. So the first day we got a pair of yarn balls, two small super cute yarn balls, and pattern part one, and then we are getting part, the different parts every day, a little bit more. So today we got this green colored yarn, this one, this beautiful color, and then we got this, look, it's purple, and it's kind of a color changing thing as well. So I think this was so cute. So so far, this is the day 7, we have done this. Where will I put myself on? So part one, or what, day 1 and 2, we did this shell boarding. Now isn't this beautiful? I mean, I have never ever knitted something like this. This is just beautiful. And then we make this part, and then we have the heel, and now we are making some flowers. So I think that this sock pattern is called Spring Socks, made by Janne Sverden. She is on Insta. I will link to her underneath this video. I will have to write it down. Link to Janne's Sverden. I will remember that. Yeah. I'm still working on socks. Yeah, well, it's on the bottom. Ooh, there. Yeah. So I'm working on some Easter socks in this bag that Janne Vie have made for me, that I won from Thorsten Gundersen. Now these socks I wanted to be done for Easter. They are called Easter Happiness Socks. Look at them, they are also cute. I would love to have them. Look at them, they are super cute, but they have not brought me any happiness at all. This is not at all. I started on it, starting on the ribbing on sock 1 and sock 2. The ribbing was way too tight and too small, so I had to rip it. And I'm working two socks at the same time, because I have such a hard time making a copy or exactly the same thing that I already have done. I'm kind of like binder on that type of person. So very often I'm working on two socks at the same time. And that was I was going to do here, because these are quite long socks. They're going up to the knee. And they will take some time. So yeah, cast on the ribbing. Look at this, isn't that wonderful? But I had to padlock it, and this type of ribbing I haven't done before either. This is a new technique for me as well. But it was too tight, too small, so I cast on the bigger, or the biggest size actually, because apparently I have chunky legs, so I thought, okay, I need chunkier pattern. So this is how far I've gotten on the one sock. I got the same on the other one, but that I, or not quite as far, but that was too tight. Now this one I'm kind of getting over or on my legs. I just have to squeeze a little bit, and I don't know if they will be comfortable to wear. So I should rip up back to these shells, this eggshells, it's called eggshells, yeah, eggshells, these eggs, because it is actually this part, this green small lines there, that are making things too tight. It fits the rest of me, but exact, but there, it is too tight. So I should rip it back and start this part again all over. If I do that, I have done this part 3 times. Now I had to do the ribbing 3 times too. So, yeah. But for not, for actually being able to get them over my legs and not being uncomfortable, I ripped the other one completely up, or up to the ribbing that I already had done several times. And now I'm working on a full needle size bigger than what it is supposed to be. So I'm working now on knitting needles 4.5 millimeter and 72 stitches. I mean, I'm knitting a sock with for the size 44 to 46 European shoe size. My feet are 37, but I'm thinking that I have to make this big for fitting my leg, and then I will just make the foot in this size of 36-7, that is my size. So hopefully my ID will work. But I'm kind of sick of them, and I'm irritated on them. So what I really want to do is to throw them in a corner and leave them, so they can lie there until they find out that they will behave nicely again. But then again, I really want to be done, and I'm not a top that quits easily. So I just have to deal with it and do it and complete them. That's just what I have to do. And they will be complete. But something else that I have had so much fun with, I don't remember if I told it in the last episode, but my neighbors next door are having a baby. So I really wanted to make them a baby blanket, and I haven't made a corner corner blanket before, so I thought I wanted to test that out, so I started on one. This is a color shifting yarn. Now, corner to corner, you can start here in this corner, and then you work out like this, making it bigger and bigger. So I will lift it up now and shut up while I show it. Yeah, so I have come as far that I have started to work my way down again. So the yarn I am using is from Cotton Kings, Sultan Deluxe from Hobby. So this colors are left in the big bowl. It's 100% cotton. The colorway, maybe somebody wants to know that, is color number 31 from the Sultan Deluxe 100% cotton from Hobby. on a 3.5 crochet hook. So this is so much fun and so relaxing to work on, and it has been kind of my social work, and I'll be working on it in the car and when I'm going away and stuff. So I really, really love this. Hopefully I will make, or I will be done with it before the baby arrives. It's arriving in April and it's just a week away, so probably not won't make it, but who knows, hey. And anyways, the baby will fit it sometimes anyways. So over I mentioned A Vertices Unite by Steven Lester. I have been wanting to make for forever, and I really wanted a green one because I don't have any green shawls, but I wanted to spin the yarn myself. So I have spent a couple of months getting some fiber. So I did get some beautiful fiber from Jovan's dogs, George and Fiona, and I spun that up, and I have been knitting that. And oh, I love it, it's so beautiful and so soft. But I also have spun up this yarn. Hopefully it is really, well, that didn't really help a lot. This maybe, no, that didn't help anything at all. Yeah, well, the color doesn't really show as it is, but it is a kind of an apple green color, so it is a really beautiful color. So got this from Stulens, that is, I got the fiber, so I spun this up. I had a advent calendar from a company called Ulvey, in this beautiful mossy green color, so I have spun that up. Not everything, but I have quite a lot left, so I spun up like 100 grams. I also bought from a Spinnvilt a patch of some merino and silk fiber called, or the color is called avocado, so it is green and some orange, yellow, brownish, yeah. And then from, I think it was Hillesvåg, I bought this fall package with different colors of some colored Norwegian white sheep. So I picked out a couple of those green shades and I spun this up. So this is some light and some darker green. It's a little bit hard to see the variation in it, but yeah, I have that. And so I spun up that fiber that I got from Jovan, and I spun up a little bit from some lamb's wool that I had, so I can put into my Vertices Unite shawl. So I put those skeins down here. So I have started, I'm working together with a friend of mine on this shawl. We are doing or starting on the different parts at the same time. So we started on part one at the same time, and then we we, or the first one, we finished, waited for the second one, and then we started part two together, and that is kind of how we are going to work on it further on as well. So now I have done part one and we have started on part two. So my part one is starting there, and this white part here, oops, that is George and Fiona, and it is so, I don't know if you actually can see, it's so fuzzy. Yeah, there you can see it. It's so fuzzy and it's so soft and beautiful, and I love it. Now I do sneeze a little bit when I or when I worked on this. So maybe I'm a little bit allergic to her dogs. Now I have 4 dogs myself, but I can still react a little bit on other dogs. But usually only in the beginning, and then I kind of work up some kind of immunity or something, but then it goes better. So I hope that this will be the same. And she washed it and I have washed it. So hopefully with time I won't have any reaction on it. Anyway, part one starts there. Then you go the way down there. And I did not have enough, so I finished part one. This is just one of my dogs. So I had to finish part one. So this green part is the end of part one, with some of that yarn from Ulvey that I spun up, and only that. So yeah, part two, I started there. So can I let it go? So this is kind of how my vertices, when I shawl looks now. Yeah. So looking forward to be done with part two, so you can work in part three and to four. And when it is done, I will have a big vertices unite shawl by hand spun yarn, or made by hand spun yarn that I have spun myself. Now how cool is that? Oh, it's going to be amazing. It has taken me some time, but I think that it's worth it anyway. And spinning yarn, it's such a fun hobby. I'm going to make a couple of short videos on Norwegian only, where I kind of show a little bit of spinning. Just because there are a whole lot of videos on English already, but there are very few on Norwegian. So if you see I'm posting videos about spinning, there probably won't be a second one on English. Now I'm making double videos. I'm making first one Norwegian video, and then a English video. So I'm making double videos, but for the spinning videos I don't think I will do that. So if you see them popping up, so you don't have to wait for the English version. But of course, if you are very eager and really want me to make one, then maybe I can. Just let me know and we will work it out. Anyways, that is what I have done and are working on now. I have a couple of other things that I'm working on, but since they're not active, I won't show them now. So yeah, that was it. I'm done. I hope that all of you have a wonderful rest of your Easter, and then until next time, stay safe, take care, and I love you all. Bye.